Good afternoon, everyone. So I would like to take us through the Asana workflow. So Asana is a work tool and also a project management tool. And using this tool, we allow us to work effectively and also be able to be accountable and be able to manage all what we are doing. So on the Asana, the Asana board is called a Kanban board, and this Kanban board is emulating the normal traditional sticky notes that can be put on a marker board in a workplace or in an office. So we have the backlog column, we have the doing column, we have the review column, and we have the done column. Once everyone is invited to this board, everybody have access to do one thing or the other. So take for instance, I want Ella to do something for me, to write a content about IETLs. So I just come here, I click on add task. So, and I write the task name, write content about IELTS for Wednesday webinar. So then I click on this icon to assign the task. To assign the task to Ella. We only have three people here because I've only invited Ola and Ella to join the board. So if I click on Ella, it's going to assign the task to Ella, and Ella will be notified that a task has been assigned to her on Asana. So if I click on this board, it's also pop out to the right where you can add more details. So here I can put a deadline. Maybe I want the this thing to be done tomorrow. I want the content to be available tomorrow. I put a deadline here. So, and I can write a description of what the task is all about. So, okay, write a content for the website and also to be posted on Twitter. So I've given more description on what should be done. So now, if I need to add a Substack, maybe I say I want to add an information on I want to add more information on what should be done. I can click on add Substack. If I click on add Substack, I can be able to write. You can say design content for Twitter shouldn't be more than 30 words. If I need to add another Substack, I click on add Substack. So here, after you've assigned it to Ella, or and Ella needs to ask a question, Ella can come here and ask a question and post it. Oh, I don't understand what you mean by it shouldn't be more than 30 words. Can you please clarify more? So the conversation is ongoing here and is on the project. So that is how you create a task under the backlog. So if you click this arrow, it will close the tab. After Ella has been notified that there's a task waiting for her, Ella is expected. Ella is expected to move this ticket. You know, she's expected to drag this ticket to doing. So that way, we are able to see that Ella is already working on this task, and she has already gotten the information. And after Ella is done with this task and needs the person that assigned the task, if when she needs the person to review it, then she moves this board to review. Then whoever created the task or assigned the task or the person she's reporting to will come here and review it. After the person has reviewed appropriately, then it can be moved to done. So that is the way to create a task on Asana and be able to work around Asana. So we have the backlog, we have the doing, we have the review, and we have done. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to, before we move a task to our backlog, I'm going to create another column where we can have, it's going to be our idea board. So when we have an idea, we just drop it there, everybody drop the idea there. Then once we've discussed about the idea and the idea is ready to be worked on, we move it to the backlog. So that is basically how we work around the Asana. Thank you.